over here at the top center, I guess you could say, we say left side of the map, is the fruit dealer. Down here on the other side, as you can see, by the way, tons of fans here showing up to show their support. We have, formerly known as Into the Rainbow, he is now known as Hope Torture.
Now, Hope Torture likes to torture people by giving them hope. Proxy's a barracks.
Oh my god.
He knows that this map is the best map for 14 command set. I'm 14 patch, rather. And that is something that, of course, our Zerg player Fruit Dealer loves to do. So if he chooses to do that, this is actually going to be just a build order win. And in fact, he's getting a gas. So this might even be
it's Reaper.
Proxy Reaper.
That's very interesting. This is just. Now, remember, there's going to be a small amount of time when the Zerg can spot. Be like, wait a minute. Uh-oh.
A lot of Zerg players don't wait for that Overlord to finish scouting because it actually doesn't get all the way across the main base before you have the minerals for the hatchery. So I think Fruit Dealer's just going to blindly expand anyways. Looks like maybe. Yeah, he does, in fact, go for the blind expansion without scouting all the way for the barracks. But of course, that barracks could be anywhere in that base.
So he's got vision of it here. He goes, wait a minute. Wait a minute. Something's going on here.
Yeah, this is... This could be quite bad.
Remember, in the patch, the Reaper build time was reduced.
Or I mean, increased
rather, excuse me.
By 5 seconds, so definitely a good fix.
But he sees it.
Here we go. Oh, my. What is he going to think here? What does he do? The SCV coming out. He's going to definitely want to try to make a bunker.
Is he going to cancel? No, I guess not.
I don't think he's going to cancel, and I think that might be the best choice. Let him attack that instead of his drones. That's what I would hope for.
Reaper. Almost out. A second one will be made soon. There it is.
Now, no gas going out yet for our Zerg player. And also Nitro Packs going up for the Reapers. I like this. Going right to the main base. Hit some drones. That's what you want to do.
Oh, this is so bad for the Zerg.
And he's got to control this perfectly. If he gets surrounded by drones, it's going to be very, very bad. Good moves here by Fruit Dealer. Two drones down. Three drones down.
We're waiting for the queen to come out. Lings are on the way.
Oh! Is he going to get in?
And no.
Gets away.
He escapes.
Barely. Barely gets away. Only two hits left to the Zerglings. It's micro time, Tasteless.
It's micro time. Micro wars here. These kids are micro machines, man.
I used to play with those when I was a kid.
Me too. excuse me. He's just gonna go for the hatchery here. There's nothing the dealer can really do about this when he goes down here.
Zerglings coming down. They want to kill that SCV. Will they get it? Yes.
Yes, they get the SCV.
Oh wow, he's gonna have to send another SCV over there for sure. And this Reaper may get surrounded. No, microed out of there. Very nice. Zerglings going for the counterattack. The Reapers have to chase. So those Zerglings. Oh, they turn right around in the smoke. Beautiful move.
Oh,
using
my
the
God.
Smoke. That is so amazing. That is what that smoke is for. Ambush. Amazing play
I can't
here.
Believe that. I cannot believe you turned around. I was positive he was just going to go for the counter trick, but that was such... Oh, my
it's,
God. That was so high level.
The smoke, that is something we don't see a lot yet. That is why Blizzard put in the game for moves like this.
Unbelievable. I cannot... Look, frankly, if this is rock, paper, scissors... This is supposed to be this builder that Terran's doing is just supposed to win automatically. Reaper
Roach.
Chased out by a Roach.
This is so crazy.
He's going to try to intercept the Reaper. Does he get it?
Ah!
And he does manage to escape going past the utility bot, formerly known as the Automaton 2000.
It's still known as that in the Green version.
Is it?
Yeah.
It's interesting.
Not really, but thank
really.
You.
So the Fruit Dealer's still in this. He did lose some drones, but he seems to be bouncing back. Remember, Terran had to sacrifice some SCVs to carry it ahead.
In fact, it's 20 drones versus 17 SCVs and a mule. But there are two hatcheries up and a queen. So he's going to be able to really use so many units. I mean, so many drones, rather, to get his economy way ahead. Right now, making a lot of roaches. I think he may just try for a counterattack here. And if all there is Reapers, it is going to kill.
Reapers are out. Nice positioning over here. Meanwhile, we have more drones being pumped out here. The Fruit Dealer likes his economy being strong.
Right now, let's take a look at these supplies. It's kind of scary. 44 against 27 from either way in the lead.
I cannot believe he held out that rush. That is actually so insane. You can see the Reapers jump down, try to get around. There's more roaches over here. He's sending just a ton of roaches. He's going to see if he can't just break them. Now, Reapers can outrun roaches, but they don't win in a one-on-one fight if they're forced to stand their ground.
Yeah, and now he's hitting these barracks. Luckily, the barracks has a lot of hit points, but he's got to get some SCVs up there. I can't believe he's not repairing this barracks right now. He should have been ready for this. And the Marauder is actually blocking the SCVs from repairing.
He's going to get it.
So bad.
He could get it. Even with this one roach not attacking, he does break it down.
The Marauders, they do a really good job against Reapers. I mean, as roaches, but he's losing so many SCVs. Oh my. Just targeting SCVs, getting so far ahead economically speaking.
He's getting, this is such a mission success here from the Brute Dealer. Just taking out SCVs. Meanwhile, these Reapers did not manage to do anything. I was watching them on the mini-map the whole time. Let's see if he can come back now, though. The Reapers hop up, but the Queen is there.
Queen taking one out.
Takes one out.
She's very protective of her baby drones.
And nope, this is denied again.
Wow, the Zerglings even have speed at this point. He's got two bases going very well. And in fact, adding a third hatchery, that is natural.
He's going to hardcore two base. Yeah, he's just going to try to take him out now.
Which is just a perfect choice right now. The Reaper Ass really didn't do enough.
Terran takes the island over here. That's one thing going for him.
Yeah, that's actually a very smart move. He realizes, you know what, I cannot get out there and actually expand my normal place, so this is what I have to do.
Nice block there. He's going to go for the barracks again. I don't know if this is a wise decision by the Fruit Dealer.
It takes a lot of hits from Marauder to actually kill a Zerg.
That's true.
He's not repairing.
What?
He just assumes the Zerg will run away, and the barracks may go down.
What?
Barracks goes down again. Fruit Dealer.
Oh, my God.
Are you serious?
You know, what's so funny about that is I saw him do that and I thought, well, he should really just turn around, you know, because the Terran could repair it. And of course, the Terran thinks, well, I can repair it, so he just needs to turn around. But then he actually called his bluff.
Yeah. Beautiful move there.
Gold Expo being taken here.
And a Spire going up.
Yep.
I don't know how you're going to deal with three base Spire after an opening like that, Hope Torture. There. You better do something ghostly.
He goes up here, takes out the SCV. You know. It's like the Terran player can never just get it started. You know what I mean? He's been so behind now.
I don't even know what his game plan is going to be from here. Turtling is going to allow Fruit Dealer to just make his Ultra Army. Maybe a Thor Drop? Okay. Thor Drop, decent idea right now.
Thor Drop on the way. He can defend the island with this.
Now, the sad thing is the Spire is just about to finish. And when that thing finishes and a bunch of mutas pop out, he has a lot of money banked up, as we see, and starts 9 mutas. And unless 5 turrets go up at that expansion, maybe 4 plus quick repairing and a Thor, maybe 3 and a Thor, I guess would actually do it. But he has to prepare for this right now. These mutas are almost done. Some turrets going up, but I think the timing on them is a bit late.
Let's see here, the Zerg. Mutas have hatched. But actually, does the Zerg actually know? The Zerg doesn't even know about the island.
Yeah.
The island, excuse me.
But an Overlord was up there, and Thor's attacking it. I think he can put two and two together.
That's true.
And here he goes. Realize, the turrets just in time there. Hope Torture's got to counter everything that Fruit Dealer does right now. Mutas going into the main base.
Mutas. Just going to see if there's any holes here. And nice. Takes out an SCV, delaying the command center. That's one small victory there. Meanwhile, the Zerg expanding again. A Fruit Dealer out of control.
Yeah, he is completely out of control here, man. He knows everything in this base. He just flew right through it. He knows what's going on. He knows how many units there are. He knows how likely an attack is at this point. He knows. I mean, this is just a great position for Fruit Dealer to be in.
Getting a Banesling nest now.
Yeah, he's doing that thing that we were talking about, getting everything at once. He's getting drops, getting speed, getting roach speed, getting a baneling nest, and droning up while expanding twice. This is how you peel apart Hope Torture, everyone.
Got a lot of drones over here, almost oversaturated at the Gold Expo, so that means he's going to be able to get a ton of stuff.
Yeah, a ton of stuff, and stuff is the right word for it, too, because it can be anything.
He's going to get everything. Yeah. Now, he's going to fly in here once again. I think he wants to intimidate Hope Torture into stimming, and he does.
Yeah, these mutas actually don't mean a lot right now. Just do whatever you can with them. The final army is probably just going to be, you know, what we've seen already from Crew Dealer. A lot of ultras, a lot of infestors, a lot of everything. But mutas, just use them for whatever you can right now. Keep Hope Torture in his base for as long as possible.
The mutas continuing to just fly around and annoy Hope Torture. The command center's on the way down here. He's going to expand again. This could be a timing where we're going to see Hope Torture attack. But then again, you know, there's so much money on the line. He might just want to sit back and take it easy.
Yeah. He may want to do that. And I think it's a pretty good idea. I
mean, he's so ahead.
Yeah, it's his game to lose from here, really. He's up 40 supply right now. He's getting every single upgrade. There's no way he's going to be attacked. It's just life is good for the Crew Dealer at the moment.
Life is not good for this one Marine. This is going to be bad.
And we got a drop. A lot of Banelings in here, a lot of Zerglings, and he's also got the Mutas to come along if he wants.
There's no way he can save this island, I think.
Yeah, I know. He should be able to take this out, or at least the SCVs.
Mutas,
and here come
the
Mutas
as
well. Here we go. This is huge. And the Zerglings start dropping out. Here come the Banes, but we don't want the Banes running into the Thor.
Oh, the Banes going into the Thor.
Yeah, that's... Well, he does kill the Thor, so that's good. And plenty of Zerglings left over. They're going to clean up. We have some dropships going to the island. And he's already lost so much over there. At this point, I want to show everyone his supply. 178 to 102.
Oh my god, talk about a difference.
Yeah. That is a huge difference. He's going to double the supply in a moment here after he gets some overlords out.
Oh my god, he's actually going to be able to get the medevacs. Now, there's a weird situation going on here because he's kind of stuck on this island.
Yeah, a huge chunk of his army. This makes it so that he cannot attack the Zerg player. He can't do it.
He's got to be careful. He's got to figure out how to get this army out of here because the Fruit Dealer's getting ready for another attack.
Looking to see if he can do anything over here. Got Banes and Overlords.
Banelings dropping on there, on the tanks.
Oh, wow.
Uh-oh.
This is going to be so gross. This is R-rated, everyone. You're under 17, turn this off.
If you have children in the room, you might want to tell them to leave or cover their eyes.
Here we go. Zerglings and Banelings being dropped. Roach is coming in. Siege Tank's going. The Banelings going after the Marines. Almost nothing left for Hope Torture. And I think we're about to crown our first GSL champion, Tasteless.
The greatest StarCraft player in the world, a Fruit Dealer, now goes back in here and takes out the island.
Everywhere at once. Totally wild.
I can't believe this. This is just insane.
Over 100 supply more than his opponent.
He stopped the build. He shouldn't have been able to stop. It was a build that was designed to directly counter his opponent. He stopped it. He drove the Terran all the way back into his base.
Oh, wow. Look at this. He's cleaning up, but there's nothing left, man. Oh! Hi. I'm making 39 Banelings. He's just making pure Zerglings at this point. Doesn't matter what he makes, because he is just worlds ahead, 178 to 86.
We got a big drop, though. Remember, Hope Torture came back from shambles in that last game.
That's
maybe
right.
He's going to do it this time.
A lot of Banelings are going to have something to say about this, I think. Here they come. Infester. Oh. This also is going to be dangerous.
Here we go.
One drops themselves units in it.
Oh, my God.
Fruit Dealer. Looks like this is it. We're going to see a GG in any second. And Fruit Dealer is going to be our champion of the first GSL. Amazing, astounding, stellar Zerg play.
This guy is so good.
Undoubtedly
he's winning with a race that nobody else can win with.
Yeah.
Right now. And he's doing it. He's got unbelievable strategies, so many different styles. By the way, I guess this is his last-ditch effort. And he doesn't
matter. Don't think so, buddy. The Goodbye Medevac, goodbye Marines. Hope torture. He's just pulling himself together for the GG, realizing that he has been destroyed.
And this is going to be it.
Look at that fearsome army. Here we go.
Perfect balance of units here. Wings, roaches, banelings, and festers.
Oh! Fungal growth, GG! Fruit Dealer is our champion. He has just won 100 million won. That's approximately 85,000 US dollars. Astounding prize for an astounding player.
He's just unlocked the biggest baller in the nerd world achievement.
That's right.
That's right. I can't believe how well he played. He totally deserved to win that.
Yeah, no doubt about it.
Way outclassed Hope Torture. Oh my God, he was so good.
Everything went perfectly well for him, man. He played his ass off, and it worked.
Well, guys, we're going to be closing this out here, but I want to personally thank you so much for joining. We love StarCraft, and we love you guys. We hope you enjoyed this season. Next season's going to be even better.
Thanks for watching.
Thank you so much, guys. We love you. So this is Tasis and Artosis signing out. We're going to have an interview, I believe, with the player on the stage. We're going to have John's going to be translating that, I believe. All right.
So that is it. GSL1 is over. It's been an amazing tournament. Thank you, everyone, for coming. And that is it.
All right. Much love, guys. Bye-bye. See you next season.
Yeah. 얼마나 감격스러운 순간입니까? 스타크래프트2를 좋아하는 그냥 이게 유저로도 지금 이 순간 소름이 돋고 있는데요. 자, 본인은 어떨지 직접 만나보도록 하겠습니다. 김원기 선수 축하합니다.
네, 고맙습니다.
네, 마이크 받아주시고요. 김원기 선수, 오늘 결승에서의 우승 예상하셨습니까?
Have you expected to win today?
첫 경기 맵이 좀 많이 힘들어갖고 첫 경기에서 조금만 괜찮다 싶으면은 우승할 수 있을 거라고
생각합니다.
자, 우승해보니 어떻습니까? 첫 메이저 대회에 첫
우승자의 경우로 오게 됐는데요. So he thought if he won in the first set, he would eventually win the whole thing.
모르겠어요, 아직 우승. 그러니까 이런 무대에서 게임한 것도 처음이고 이렇게 많은 분들 앞에서 게임한 것도 다 처음이어갖고 그냥 모르겠어, 멍해요. 그냥 우승한 것 같지도 않고 그냥.
It doesn't feel.
자, 김원기 선수의 우승은
he can't yet believe that he has won.
It's his
first time to play in front of so many crowd.
들리시죠?
네, 들립니다.
김원기 선수를 향한 박수입니다. 우승을 축하하는 함성입니다. 자, 우리 팬 여러분들께 한 말씀 부탁드릴게요.
이렇게 오늘 비도 오는데 와주셔서 너무 감사하고요.
Thank you for coming today, even though it's raining. And Zerg fighting.
자, 지금 가장 머릿속에 떠오르는 분위기시다면 누가 떠오르나요?
맹독충이요.
Who pops into your head right at the moment? And he answered, Baelings.
네. 여러분들께서는 지금 세계 최고 최강 우승자의 맹독충의 의인화를 지켜보셨습니다. 자, 글쎄요, 연습도 굉장히 많이 도와준 동료들도 있을 것이고 부모님도 있을 것이고요. 네, 감사의 말씀 전하실 분들이 있을 것 같아요.
일단 오늘 이렇게 아시는 분들이 많이 올지 몰랐어요. 일단 부모님부터 해갖고 아는 형들, 친구들, 뭐 친척형, 친동생.
We thanking all his cousins and family for coming today.
그러니까 원래는 즐기자였는데, 그러니까는 이렇게 아시는 분들 많이 오니까는 이겨야겠다 생각이 더.
At first, he was just going to enjoy the final.
너무 많이 와주신 분들 때문에.
But since so many people he knew came, he was determined to win.
두 번째부터는 그래도 제 실력대로 잘할 수 있었던 것 같습니다. 다 고맙습니다.
네, 감사합니다. 여러분들은 김원기 선수에게 박수로, 또 김원기 선수는 이렇게 감사하다는 담례. 네, 아주 좋은 장면입니다. 자, 우승 다시 한번 축하 말씀 드리고요. 자, 오늘은 왠지 좀 아쉬움도 남아있는 밤이 될 것 같습니다. 자, 김성재 선수 수고하셨습니다.
수고하셨습니다.
네. 자, 여러분, 김성재 선수에게 뜨거운 박수 부탁드리겠습니다.
Now interview with Hope Torture.
김성재 선수가 개인적으로 멋있었던 이유는 항상 즐기는 마인드를 가졌기 때문이었는데요. 자, 오늘 이 무대 위에 오르면서 사실 욕심이 났었을 것도 같아요. 자, 지금 자 준우승을 했습니다. 자, 한 말씀 부탁드릴게요.
좀 너무 좀 생각한 대로 못해가지고 좀 많이 아쉽기는 하지만
feels his shame. He hasn't played.
우승한 김원기 선수 정말 축하드리고
and he's congratulating Fruit Dealer.
아쉽게 우승 못했지만 다음에 꼭
and even though he lost today.
계기가 됐으면 좋겠습니다.
This is going to provide a motivation for him to do better next time.
김성재 선수 역시 대한민국 아닌 세계 최강 테라님입니다. 자, 지금 김성재 선수의 어머님의 모습인데요. 네, 그 마음을 제가 대변해도 되겠습니까? 잘했다, 성재야. 오늘 수고했다라고 전하고 싶으시죠, 어머니? 네. 자, 이 똑같은 마음을 저희 팬들은 또 가지고 있으니까 김성재 선수, 오늘은 아쉽게 준우승을 했지만 다음 시즌2에서는 반드시 우승을 하실 생각이시죠? 자, 시즌2에 임하는 각오한 말씀 부탁드리겠습니다.
사실 이제 다른 선수들에 비해서 제가 좀 게임을 늦게 시작하고 좀 그 이 자리가 어떻게 보면은 저한테는 좀 과분한 자리였다고도 약간 생각 들어요. 왜냐면은 저보다 훨씬 노력을 많이 하고
because he has started StarCraft 2 much later than other players.
그런 부분에서
he feels he may not up to be
좀
he doesn't deserve to be in such a big stage.
시즌2는 이제 정말 저도 열심히 해서 한 번 더 도전을 해보겠습니다.
But in season
2, 네, 알겠습니다. 저희는 항상 지지하고 응원하도록 하겠습니다.
Much, much
박수 부탁드리겠습니다. 네.
man, this is hard.
물어보지 않을 수가 없습니다. 그렇죠, 최정원에서? 네, 아주 중요한 부분인데요.
네.
상금이 일반적인 대회의 상금, 물을 웃돌기 때문입니다. 네. 목소리 나는 1억 상금을 어디에 쓰실 것인지 네. 네, 궁금하지 않으십니까?
Okay, now we're going to ask Fruit Dealer where he's going to use the prize money, 100 million Korean won.
받으면은 어디다 쓰시겠습니까?
과일 가게요? 이 호점이요? 네.
일단 어디다 쓸지 생각은 한 번도 해본 적 없어요.
He haven't thought about it yet.
1등할 거란 생각도 못했었고. 그냥 매 경기 다 떨어질 것 같았거든요. 그래갖고 상금에 대한 그런 거는 모르겠어요. 아직 생각 안 해봤어요.
Yeah, 네.
그래요. 근데 어머님께서는
every round he wasn't sure he was going to win, so he hasn't really thought about what he was going to do with the prize money.
어렸을 때 준다고 했던 세뱃돈 아직까지 못 받았는데 네. 그거부터 받고 드리겠습니다.
네, 예, 알겠습니다.
Yeah, he's not sure he's going to give the money to his parents.
오늘 이 무대 장충체육관을 가득 메운 네, 세컨드 투 팬들의 축제가 끝났습니다. 조금 전에 이윤재 감독의 모습이 보였는데요.
네.
네, 기분 좋으시죠? 네, 오늘이 바로 이윤재 감독을 비롯한 우리 김원기 선수 팬들의 인생에서 가장 기쁜 날이 아닌가 하는 생각이 들면서 자, 저희는 이제 시상식으로 이어지도록 하겠습니다.
Now we're going to have the awarding ceremony.
인테코리아가 협찬하고 분자대 엔터테인먼트가 후원하며 곰TV가 주최한 최초의 세컨드 투 메이저리그 이제 본격적인 시상식이 이어집니다. 자, 먼저 준우승에 대한 시상이 있겠습니다.
First, we're going to award the second
시상해
place.
주실 분을 무대로 모시겠습니다. 인텔코리아의 송원기 상무님을 무대로 모십니다. 큰 박수 부탁드립니다.
Mr. Song Won-ki from Intel Korea, Executive Director.
티지3번 인텔 Secret 2 오픈 시즌 1 준우승 김성재! 김성재 선수 수고하셨습니다. 그리고 더 발전하는 김성재 선수를 기다리고 있겠습니다. 준우승을 하신 김성재 선수에게는 준우승 상금 3천만 원이 주어집니다. 축하드립니다. 네, 여러분 다시 한번 박수 부탁드리겠습니다. 네, 송원기 상무님 감사드리고요. 자, 이제 오늘의 메인 무대입니다. 네. 우승자에 대한 시상이 있겠습니다. 먼저 시상해 주실 분을 무대로 모셔보죠. 주식회사 TG3부 컴퓨터의 우명구 본부장님을 큰 박수로 맞이해 주십시오. 자, 이제 우승자에 대한 시상입니다. TG3부 컴퓨터와 인텔코리아가 협찬하고 블리자드 엔터테인먼트가 후원하는 TG3부 인텔 스타크래프트 2 오픈 시즌 1 그 영광의 우승자는 바로 과일장수 김
the first champion of the first GSL.
그 첫 우승자가 가려졌습니다. 초대 우승자 김원기, 정우의 아무개, 란세의 영웅이 된 김원기 선수는 명백히 전 세계 최강의 스타크래프트 선수임이 밝혀졌습니다. 초대 우승자 김원기 선수에게는 상금 1억 원이 수여됩니다. 다시 한번 축하의 박수 부탁드리겠습니다. 네, 축하드립니다. 네, 무거우시죠? 자, 이렇게 해서 시상식까지 마치게 된 선수들입니다. 자, 오늘은 시작입니다. 이제 글로벌 e스포츠
This is just the beginning. We have upcoming seasons. I hope you have enjoyed watching GSL Season 1.
김성재라는 이름이 쓰여지게 됐습니다. 자, 글로벌 e스포츠 리그다운 GSL 내년 2011년 본격적인 행보를 시작하게 되는데요. 자, 최정원 해설.
네.
자, 드디어 탄생했습니다.
그렇죠. 1억 원의 주인공, 거기다가 초대 챔피언이 탄생을 했고 많은 분들이 응원해 주셨고 스타크래프트 2를 즐기셨던 많은 분들이 이 현장에 와주셨습니다. 정말 감사드리고 앞으로도 시즌 2, 시즌 3 여러분들의 의견 계속해서 듣고 여러분들과 함께하는 봄TV GSL이 되겠습니다. 여러분 감사합니다.
네. 자, 이어서 우리 안준영 해설도 한 말씀 부탁드릴게요.
네. 다가오는 시즌 2가 더더욱 기대되는 현장이 아닐 수가 없는데요. 시즌 2의 선수들의 열기와 함께 저희도 꺼지지 않는 불꽃처럼 언제나 타오르는 열정으로 여러분들 준비할 것을 약속드리겠습니다. 감사합니다.
Sharing their opinions.
네, 글로벌 e스포츠 새로운 자멜리언 TG 3보 인텔 세컨드 2 오픈 시즌 1 결승전 우승자만큼이나 또 감사드리고 싶은 분들이 있습니다. 사실 오늘 결승전에 올라오며 준비를 하는 과정에서 이 두 선수들에게 뜨거운 함성을 보여주고 싶었던 저희 스태프들의 마음과 스타트 유저들의 마음이 있었을 텐데요. 자, 오늘 장충체육관을 가득 메워주신 우리 스타크래프트 유저분들에게 다시 한번 고개 숙여 깊은 감사의 말씀을 전하고 싶습니다. 자, 모두 여러분들을 위한 순간입니다. 여러분 감사합니다.
감사합니다.
Thank you.
자, 그럼 저희는 더 나은, 더 준비된, 더 발전하는 시즌2를 기약하며 이만 물러갑니다. 훨씬 더 당당하고 멋진 무대로 돌아오겠습니다. 여러분 행복한 밤 보내시기 바라겠습니다. 안녕히 계십시오.